Former President Bill Clinton speaks tonight, 10 Eastern time, 7 p.m. out west. It's going to be his seventh straight Democratic convention speech. Joining us right now, somebody who's definitely going to be watching the speeches as well, Reggie Love. He's President Obama's former personal assistant, or body man, as some people like to call you. You're from Charlotte, right?
I am. Grew up here. Went to elementary, middle school, and high school here in Charlotte.
And, of course, Duke.
And Duke. So I tell everyone all the time, if you would have said 15 years ago that there would be a Democratic National Convention in Charlotte, North Carolina, I would have said no way. But who says that hope and change don't happen? So progress in motion.
And you're only 30, and you have big plans. I know you're in business school. Things are moving very well for you. But tell me a little bit about, we heard Michelle Obama, the first lady, saying her husband hasn't changed. The presidency hasn't changed him at all. You know him very well. I mean, what do you think? Has he changed? Is he the same guy? Describe for us a little bit about who this guy is as someone you intimately know.
So I think Michelle was spot on. I think the priorities and the things that are ultimately core to the president have not changed in the last 3.5 years. I think more than anything, I think the responsibilities and the pressures have probably become a little bit heavier, and his sense of urgency to make sure those core values are seen throughout the rest of the country has definitely increased over the last 3 years. As we all know, it's been a tough couple of months, but growth has been happening, and we've seen new jobs being created. We've seen economic growth over the last 29 months. So I think he hasn't changed at all, but he's definitely working to make things better for everyone.
When you guys talk, what do you talk about?
Mostly sports. and in the summertime, we talk about the classic sports. But and then we also talk about some of the things you see, you know, when you're traveling out in the country, you run into families and to kids who you've been able to affect. And I know when he passed the healthcare legislation, there were a lot of moments out there where you'd run into families who basically felt like they were no longer going to be devastated because of a pre-existing condition that one of their family members had. And those kind of things are always moving. And I think it's grounding for him. It's grounding for his staff. And it's good to know that, you know, regardless of all the things, all the back and forth that you have in D.C. at times, it's good to know that you're actually out there making a difference.
Michelle, last night, she talked about being the mom in chief, and she talked about that 4 years ago. That was the most important thing for her, is to have this kind of environment where her two daughters are protected. How has the president, how has he evolved as a father? What is he like?
I think he's been, I think it's a very difficult thing to do. But being president is actually a lot easier than it was during the campaign. As you remember, I mean, in 2007 and 2008, he traveled 5, 6, 7 days a week. And so over the last 3.5 years, he's been able to, like she mentioned, you know, spend time with him, have dinner almost every night of the week. I think you guys remember he's been able to, like, coach Sasha's basketball games and sort of, you know, I think obviously being a parent is, I'm not a parent, so I'm not an expert, but obviously in being a parent, I know the best thing about my parents was that they were around. And having someone, even though they are the President of the United States, be around for those moments is really an amazing thing to be able to do.
Is he more protective of his daughters now that he's they're approaching their teen years?
Well, you saw that picture. They look very grown, man. Every day, I'm always taken back by how fast they're growing up. But, of course you're protective of beautiful young ladies like that. At least if I had daughters, I would be. You'll be the same way.
That's right. Do you guys keep in touch? Does he text, email?
I still have my place in D.C., so we have a pickup game every now and then. I think of him as a mentor, a friend, and like a big brother. So, you know, there are not many decisions that I make that I don't try to at least sort of give him a heads up on or get his opinion on. And I'm grateful to have those kind of insightful conversations with him.
Yeah, you got the direct dial to the president. That's not bad. All right, Reggie, good to see you as
Thanks,
always.
Suzanne.
Yeah, congratulations.
Suzanne, thank you for having me.
All right.